part of what we do is provide a balance of use amongst a myriad of natural resources, and for us to be able to sustain that over time.
We realize and understand that we're stewards of the forest. It's actually a public asset. Everybody owns the forest equally. We do our best to try to manage in a way that provides the most resources for everybody.
Making sure that this is a healthy place for these animals to exist, and we don't end up with problems like soil erosion and a lack of food for these animals. We humans have to consider what are the capacities of the land for them all.
When we're looking at management, we can't let it be overpopulated by one species. It all goes back to everything being in a balance and everything being healthy so that everything can coexist together.
We have a horse territory on the Black Mesa Ranger District. It's my job as the district ranger to manage and balance it with the other resources, whether it's livestock grazing, whether it's recreational use, timber management. All those things need to be balanced, and the horses are a part of that balance in the proper numbers.
The Heber Wild Horse Territory was established in 1974. The horse is a beautiful creature. They're majestic. They have a lot of, mystique about them and grandeur. These horses that are living out on the landscape now, they're perfectly capable of reproducing. They reproduce about 20% per year. So you look at a population of horses, within 5 years, that population has doubled.
I'm a permittee on the National Forest. The wild horses affect us a lot. All animals on the forest are managed. The cows are managed, the wildlife's managed, but the horses aren't. The pastures that I have horses in, we worry that we can even go into that pasture because we only have permission to graze 25% of the grass. And that's not only the cows, that's whatever's out there eats 25. If it got to the point that that 25% was gone in all of our pastures, then we're not allowed to come on the forest.
We are a real small town, rural community. Our community here has always relied on the forest for its economy. The horses have always been here and they've always been a part of our community. Our local high school is named the Mustangs after the wild horses. I believe that the horses are a good part of our community, that they do draw a lot of tourism, which helps fuel our economy here.
One of the key concerns and issues that we have here is everything else on the forest is managed. But unfortunately, the horse situation right now as it is, it's unmanaged. It's not in a sustainable situation. There is a potential for horses or anything else that's unmanaged to have negative impacts on the habitat and the land.
The limiting factor is water. And last year we had a severe drought and all the tanks went dry. If there's too many horses, we really have no solution. The Heber Wild Horse Collaborative was created to try to bring in primary stakeholders to see if some recommendations could be developed that could be passed on to the U.S. Forest Service for their consideration in writing a management plan for this horse herd.
Right now we're currently working through a management plan. When we receive the management plan in its approved form, that will allow us to determine a number that will be in balance with the territory that we have here on the district.
I have no problem having horses here if they were managed. They need to decide how many horses can be here and then keep them there.
I'm anxiously awaiting a proposed management plan, and I hope a component of that is to involve stakeholders into the future to co-manage all these resources.
I think in order to have a successful program, we have to have multiple parties coming together. There's going to be give and take from everybody. But I think what we have to all remember is that the Apache-Sitegreaves National Forest belongs to all of us. Because ultimately, what we're all trying to do is protect this beautiful land, and we have to do that together.